Hi, this is Amy, and I want to show you some applications of Google Docs in the English as a Second Language classroom, or when you're working with students who maybe are new to the country, maybe there's no one who speaks their language in your building. This can give you a way to translate assignments, a way to communicate, a way for students to turn in work when they don't yet have any English, or to help them learn English. So I'm going to show you two different techniques today. The first one is going to be changing the language of your Google Docs and having the language match the current language of the student so that the student can speak in his or her native language and communicate through Docs. So as you can see, I just changed the language of this particular Google Doc to French. So I just clicked on File. And I went down to Language, and I selected French from the menu. Now you can see there are, I don't know, hundreds of languages here. And the student, you know, may be able to just point so that they can help you recognize their native language if you don't know how to find it. All right, so our document is now in French, and now we're going to go and use voice typing. So we're going to click on Tools and Voice Typing. And now we need to make one more change. So right now, the microphone is listening for English, but we want it to listen for French in this particular example. So I'm going to scroll down and choose French. And when I get ready to type with my voice, I'll just click the microphone and start to speak. Bonjour, comment allez-vous aujourd'hui? So you can see that the voice typer typed in the language that we selected. So now let's practice another application. Let's pretend that now we need to take a document that has been typed in the student's native language, and we need to know what it says. And maybe we don't speak French or the student's language, so we want to go to Tools and Translate Document. And we're going to choose the destination language as English and choose Translate. Now, our first document is still over here. It's still sitting there just like it was, and a new document has now been created, and this is going to show us our translation into English. So now we have it in English. And just one more step, I'll show you if maybe this is an assignment and we want our students to do this assignment and we don't have any way to communicate that to the student. We can go to Tools, Translate Document, and now we'll select the student's native language from the list. And this time I'll choose Spanish and I'll click Translate. And then the same document that started out in French, we changed it to English, is now going to be switched over to Spanish. So I hope that gives you another way to communicate with your English language learners or to work with your foreign language learner students. Have a great day.